Here is, what if Deku was the son of the Dragon King? We start the story with two dragon lovers. The dragon princess of another dragon clan, Ingo, the flaming water dragon, and her lover, Hasashi, the prince of the earth fire clan. They're both destined to be lovers, but they started out as friends. They never really cared about their redemption that way. But over time, they decided to get more and more close to each other, thus becoming boyfriend and girlfriend. Then one day, they started dating, and after 137 dates, Hasashi finally proposed to Ingo. And then, the long lives of becoming queen and king became sealed. They've been on this earth for many, many years, up to the point Quirks was born. And this is around the time when Ingo is pregnant with Isuku, when it's time to Ingo to lay the egg. Isuku was finally hatched into the world. And now, we get off to the story. When Isuku was hatched, he looked like a baby version of this, what you see in the picture. And they both wonder what his fire breath could be. Ingo thought it could be her water and fire breath. Hasashi said it could be his fire breath and earth breath. As they went to the quirk doctor, the quirk doctor said, "Well, Mr. Midoriya, it's clear that he inherited both your quirks, but he has different breaths." As they looked at each other confused and said, "Wait, this is Hasashi saying, different breaths? What do you mean?" As the doctor said, "Well, little Isuku here have ice breath, lightning breath, fire breath, earth breath, water breath, and metal breath, and shadow breath. And finally, the most powerful of them all, golden breath." Both Ingo and Hasashi were surprised. Hasashi said, "He's more powerful than our family combined." As Ingo said, "This kid is one unique dragon, to say the least." As Isuki said, "I'm going to become the most powerful dragon here ever. No one can beat me with this." As the doctor just chuckled and said, "You can even ride for our might." As Isuki just pointed and said, "Wait a minute. I can't always rely on my breaths, since there's always situations where I can't use my quirk." As Isuki didn't know, he's a dragon, so quirks don't really, affect him, actually. So, Isuki decided to train himself in martial arts, and every single discipline, and every single martial arts in the world. And he became a master of all of them at 15. As Isuku became at Batman's level of skill and strength. After his last day of training, his master bowed down to him, saying, "You done well, Master Dragon." As Isuku bowed down to him, saying, "No. It was an honor to be trained by you and my other masters. And then, he went to study but never missed out on his martial arts training. As for Bakugo, Bakugo and Izuku are actually really close friends. In fact, Bakugo gave him the nickname Bulldust, since he's really like a bull, and his favorite anime involves bulls for some reason. As the teacher came in to the classroom and did his whole speech, Bakugo Kosuke's speech was a lot different this time. He said both him and Izuku are the only two people that is worth a crap to be in your area. The rest of you could join a lonely D-lister. As FBI was right pissed at Kosuke for his cockiness and arrogance. But they like Izuku a lot more because he's a lot more humble and has a lot more honor and more chill than Bakugo. After that, Bakugo asks Izuku, can he hang out with you? As Izuku said, sure, you can hang out. We can hang out at my home. But not all the time. You still have to get ready for the UA exams. As Bakugo scoffed and said, come on, nerd. You're always strong enough and scared enough. Do you ever take breaks? As Izuku said, I take breaks. It's just that sometimes I like to train after my breaks. As Bakugo laughed and said, whatever, nerd. I see you later. As Izuku didn't take that shortcut, so the sludge training never happened. After the 10 months of training and studying, he was more than confident enough to pass both portions of the exam. In the intelligence part, he came in first place, beating Yasuroji. Then, time for the fun part, the practical exams. Ila defend scarred Izuku, but Izuku scolded Ila for interrupting a teacher. Then Ila just turned around and bowed to President Mike, apologizing profusely for interrupting him. Then he turned around and thanked Deku for stopping him in his tracks. As Izuku said, no problem, man. Just make sure you wait before someone. Just make sure you wait so they can finish. Then they went outside. Everybody just now noticed that Izuku was a little dragon. As he was just doing some push-ups, sit-ups, and stretches. Then one of them walked up to Izuku. And this was Ila and said, excuse me, what's your name? As Izuku said, my name is Izuku Midoriya. As he said, where am Midoriya? Do you notice that you're a, literal dragon? Because people with dragon quirks don't exist in this what if. As Izuku said, yeah, it's part of my quirk. In fact, everyone in my family has a dragon quirk, but they each have different breaths. As Ida says, oh, what do you mean by different breaths? As Izuku said, well, on my mother's side, she have fire and water breath. On my dad's side, he have fire and earth breath. But I'm unique. I have ice breath, water breath, fire breath, earth breath, lightning breath. Did I say ice away? Yeah, I said ice away. And earth breath and my own unique breath, Golden Breath. As Ela raised an eyebrow and said, "Oh, so what's that mean in your family?" It means that I'm more unique to say. But since I can't, not on my breath, I train in martial arts a lot. As Prince Mike says, as Isuku saw the doors opening, then he says fly through there. He was faster than either by flying and running. As Prince Mike said, "What are you doing? This is no Kaido scenario battle. Go, go, go!" As everybody stopped and looked in awe, because Isuku have a really good technique. He was running up the walls of the building, casting more air pressure, and getting a drop on the robot, and was saving a lot more people than anyone else. And then, when he saw Oshoko was about to fall, he catches her beforehand, and because stands straight up, then just allow her to finish her test after he used every single breath on the zero pointer, and he accidentally burned a female 1, 2, and 3 pointers. Isuku got more than All Might record, even making his own record in UA history. As the test was over, everybody went home. As everybody was impressed by Isuku, because he didn't even break a sweat. After that, we spent the rest of the week training and training some more, even sparring with his dad, because Isuku taught his parents some martial arts too. And they got a letter in the mail. It was for Isuku. He was accepted and got first place in both portions, and even created his own record. And he was accepted in class 1A. Isuku was super excited and went out hunting for some fish, because he doesn't like normal human food. He likes to eat 100 raw fish. So then, Isuku ate his dinner and went to bed. After that, he woke up and put on his uniform for UA. Everybody waved at Isuku. Everybody was just giving Isuku glares because they wonder how he got first place in the UA entrance exam. When he got in U1A, everybody stopped talking and started looking at Isuku. Isuku got really uncomfortable and decided to just look down, as Ida just put his chin up and said, "Sorry, we're just not used to a dragon being in a school yet." As Isuku said, "It's fine, just don't stare. It makes me uncomfortable." As Ida said, "Is that for all dragons or..." "Well, it's not for all dragons, but it's for some dragons. I'm one of those some dragons." As Kurosumas was running up to Isuku and said, "Dude, why do you look so manlier? And why you look better than everyone else here?" As Isuku said, "Oh, well, my mother always did tell me I inherited both their good looks." As Kurosumi just had his mouth on the floor saying, "Man, you're even humble about looking good and feeling good." As Isuku said, "Thanks." As he looked down and saw a huge worm ancestors picked up the big woman and said, Mister, I don't think you're supposed to sleep on UA grounds or bring sleeping bags. As he secrets his unsecured sleeping bag and put it in his backpack. You can have this bag at the end of the day. As I said, come on, man, I'm tired. As Isiki said, sign eraser head, rules are rules. As Isaiah said, we have a real follower. As Isiki said, nope, my parents just raised me like this. As Tanita said, your parents must be very strict. As Isiki said, no, dragon parents are not that strict, to be honest. But they are very, very worrisome and caring about the kids. And yes, they can, and yes, they do have rules. And so it's like, oh, dragon cubs, we have to follow them. So yeah. As I said, you're a kiss up to your parents, you know that? As the secret said, what's a kiss up? As I said, how old are you? As the secret said, I'm 15. As I said, how old is your parents? As the secret said, 345. As he looked at a secret and said, how are they that old? As the secret said, as a dragon, we have a pretty long lifespan. Dragons don't die until they're at least 5068. As everybody just look at Isiku, and then Ida said, so that means you can have a long and healthy life. As Isiku said, yep, 100 fish, raw. As everybody just looked at him and said, why that? That's our diet. As I said, no, let's have a quick fire-raising test. As he put out a gym uniform, and they had one specially made for Isiku since his body type is a lot different than others. And I'm just gonna skip the scene with Mineta because Isiku just destroyed Mineta. And when he saw a pink girl, he blushed profusely because he never really talked to women. As Kirishima said, you okay there, bro? As Isiku said, yeah, just a little bit distracted. As Isiku just turned around, catch the ball, and then, out of instinct, he just threw up the ball and released every single breath of his, making him have infinity and beyond. As I said, good, I didn't have to tell you to throw the ball, but you didn't have to brief, what was those? As Isiku said, I have fire, lightning, ice, water, earth, and gold flames. As I was surprised and said, what's your family's quirk? As the secret said, on my mom's side, you see, have water and fire breathing. On my dad's side, fire and earth. As he was impressed and said, let's continue this. As Isiku got first place in every single one, and he wasn't even tired. Where everybody was just wetting up a puddle and was breathing like they're having a last day on Earth. They were surprised at Isiku, and one of them said, dude, why you're not tired? As Isiku said, I'm a dragon. I have better stamina than humans. As everybody says, said, is there any limit to your power? As Sika said, I don't know, but I can't rely on my breath too much, so I study in martial arts. As I saw was shocked and said, Yumi's fight, right here, right now. As Isuka said, okay. As I was shocked and said, you're not going to object to that? As Isuka said, nope, you're the teacher. And what you say goes, if you want me to fight you, then I'll fight you. As Aizawa said, as they decide to fight, Isuka was more skilled and a ton more martial arts and discipline than Aizawa's. But Aizawa had the scarf and had the eye thing. But that didn't work on Isuka at all. After what seemed like hours of them fighting, Isuka pinned Aizawa to the ground and said, so you wanna go again, Mr. Aizawa? Or no, sir? As Aizawa said, no, that's enough. You're already proving you're stronger. As he just stand up and pick up Aizawa. Then he gave him an apple and he had a box with him the whole time. And as I said, what's in the box? As the kid said, and she says, open up, and there was a box of different types of cookies, and the whole school smelled it. And as I said, why you brought cookies? As the kid said, well, I didn't want to come here empty-handed, so I decided to bake some cookies for my class. As everybody said, Mary has some? As Isuka said, yeah, of course. They're all for you and the teacher. As everybody in UA and 1A decided to run to Isuka because they can smell the cookies. As Isuka said, you have to rest the day off. Now fly. Fly away. As Isuka said, yes, sir. And that's what gonna end the story off. This is Crimson, your favorite viral ever. Stay safe, stay fiery, and I see you in part 2. If you want to see more of this, please leave a like down below. Comment, and subscribe. If you want to see more, share it with your friends. Bye bye now.